Here in our next example, we should begin by isolating our trig function. I'm going to add 3 to both sides first. This cancels, and I have 4 sine squared x equals 3. My next step is to divide both sides by 4. That cancels here. And I'm left with sine squared x equals 3/4. Now, in order to just get sine instead of sine squared, I need to take the square root of both sides. Now remember, when you take a square root, you get both a positive and a negative, square root 3/2. So now I'm looking for where sine is both positive and negative. That's going to include all quadrants. Now that'll be here, 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 and here. Now, which trig function or which angle has sine x equal to square root 3/2? And that's going to be 60 degrees for each of these here. So I can see that x equals pi over 3, 2 pi over 3, 4 pi over 3, and 5 pi over 3 on the interval from 0 to 2 pi. But if I want my general solution, once again, to get from this angle to here, I only have to add pi, and I will get all of those. So I know x can equal pi over 3 plus pi n, and that will handle those two. And then if I go from this angle, all I've got to do is add pi, and I get down to all multiples of those. So x also equals 2 pi over 3 plus pi n. So notice the visuals are helpful when you're sketching your reference angles to see which multiples of pi or 2 pi you need to add for your general solution.